Dear friends, my name is Nausheen Nizami and I work as an assistant professor in economics at PDPU. In today's session, I am here to discuss with you what are the implications of the recent changes in monetary policy announced by RBI on 17th April 2020. In today's session, we are going to focus our attention only on the implications of reduction in reverse repo rate and introduction of TLTRO, which are targeted long-term repo operations. So let us discuss first what are the changes in the rates. So reverse repo rate has been reduced by 25 basis points from 4% to 3.75%. Repo rate currently stands at 4.4% and marginal standing facility rate stands at 4.65%. Now let us recall the meaning of all these terms before we start analyzing the implications. So, reverse repo rate is the rate at which commercial banks lend to RBI. Repo rate is the rate, interest rate at which RBI lends to commercial banks. And marginal standing facility is an additional window. It's an additional facility given by RBI wherein commercial banks can borrow additional funds from RBI by using some of their liquid assets which they store as statutory liquidity ratio. Now, what are the implications of increasing the gap between repo and reverse repo rate as has been recently done? So, whenever RBI or any central bank is increasing the gap between repo and reverse repo rate, it implies that it is trying to ease liquidity, it's trying to inject liquidity in the economy, and these kinds of measures are generally undertaken when the economy is in slowdown or it is moving towards recession, or there is shortage of liquidity in the economy because of internal or external reasons. Now, whenever reverse repo rate is reduced, it implies that the interest income of commercial banks obtained by lending to RBI is reducing. So now if commercial banks are going to get less interest income from lending to RBI, they can look for alternative options where they can lend. Or it basically implies that the liquidity with the commercial banking system will increase. Now, what's the benefit of injecting liquidity in the banking system? How does it help? How does it help the common man? So for that, it's important to understand that whenever there is enough liquidity in the banking system, you will see its impact coming on the lending rates and they would be reduced. So basically, borrowers benefit directly from this move because generally the commercial banks will pass on these benefits on loans. So the lending rate on loans will decrease, and so the borrowers now have to pay less interest rate on loans taken from commercial banks. So it basically helps both the households as well as the institutions. Now, what is the benefit of increasing the corridor, what is known as monetary policy rate corridor, which is the difference between marginal standing facility rate and reverse repo rate. So as I said earlier, the higher the gap, more is the liquidity in the economy. More the liquidity in the economy, more ambience, better ambience has been created for stimulating economic activity. Now, let us see what are these TLTRO. So TLTRO, its full form is Targeted Long-Term Repo Operations. Now, what are these? How are they different from repo and reverse repo rate, which are also part of liquidity adjustment facility? So how are these targeted long-term repo operations basically function, and what is its impact on economy? Let's discuss this in detail. So for that, it's important for me to tell you that the normal repo and reverse repo transactions are generally on an overnight basis only. That means that these are loans which are either taken by commercial banks from RBI for one day, or loans taken by RBI from commercial banks for one day. Now, targeted long-term repo operations are different from the usual repo and reverse repo transactions because they are additional loans which commercial banks can take from RBI at the same interest rate as given by repo rate. So basically, it is a facility. It is an additional window being provided by by RBI to commercial banks, wherein commercial banks can borrow more funds from RBI for a longer duration. And the duration is generally 1 year, 2 year, and even 3 years. So basically, commercial banks have to pay the same interest rate as they are paying for a one-day loan for a loan taken under TLTRO for say 1 year, 2 year, or 3 years. So basically, it's a win-win situation for commercial banks because they don't have to pay high interest rate for long-term loans, which is the general case. So in this case, commercial banks are directly benefiting. They will be able to borrow additionally from RBI at the same interest rate. And how is it going to benefit economy? So basically, if commercial banks start borrowing more from RBI under TLTRO facility, then there would be more liquidity with the banking system. It will again imply that this benefit of liquidity will pass on to households, to borrowers, to institutions, and it will help in stimulating economic activity. So more money can be used for productive purposes, which is basically the motive behind all these changes in the monetary policy. So in general, central bank is trying to stimulate economic activity once the lockdown is over and once all the workers return back to their workplaces and all institutions plan expansion of businesses. So this is a direct move to benefit the economy. I hope you could understand this, the implications of these changes on the common man and on the business men. Take care of all of your health, and all of you have a great time ahead. Thank you.